The 8th Legion, the Night Lords, were a force that shaped cruelty and fear into a weapon and were known for their widespread use of psychological terror tactics. During the Great Crusade, they were always viewed by other Imperial forces with unease. Hello, and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint your Legionnaire in the color of the Night Lords. So, grab those paintbrushes, shake those paint pots, and let's get started. So the first thing that we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've used Chaos Black Spray. The first base paints that we're going to use is going to be Night Lord Blue for the armor, followed by Corvus Black, then Word Bearers Red, and finally Iron Warriors for the metallics. So what I need to do is get some Night Lord's Blue onto the palette. A little bit more. Some water just to thin it out. Yeah, that's good. And then just start applying that all over the model. When it's dry, just do a second thin coat. With the Night Lord's Blue applied, the next thing that we need to do is use Corvus Black and do it on the gun casing, as well as the ribbings. With that stage complete, the next thing that we need to do is pick out all the cables and lenses with Word Bearers Red. Just take your time when doing this, and if you make any mistakes, just go back over with the previous color. And with that stage complete, the next thing that we need to do is use Iron Warriors to pick out all the metallics. And for this, we're going to be going for the bolt gun on the backpack and also the stubs on the shoulder pad. And there we go. With the Iron Warriors applied, our basing is now complete. The next thing to do is to move on to the shading, and for this we're going to be using non-oil. However, the first thing that you need to do is to make sure that you've got a fresh pot of water, because you don't want any metallic flakes going to the rest of your paints. So what I need to do is use non-oil and applying that onto the miniature. So I'm just going to fill up my brush here straight from the pot. What I'm going to look to do is just putting it all over the metallic areas, as well as the black and the red, and then just putting it into the recesses of the armor. And there we go. With the shading complete, we now need to move on to the highlights. And for this, we're going to be using Cantor Blue followed by Latok Blue for the armor. And for the metallics, we're going to be using Iron Hand Steel. And then finally, for the red details, we're going to be using Evil Sun Scarlet followed by Fire Dragon Bright. So the first thing I need to do is get some Cantor Blue onto my palette. Go and then just get some water just to thin it down, and then just start getting my brush to a nice sharp point. And what we're going to be looking to do is using the side of the brush just to pick out all the edge highlights of the armor. Just take your time when doing this, and if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with the previous layer, which is Night Lord's Blue. With that first edge highlight complete, we're now going to use a Latok Blue and apply that within the lines of the first edge. Just take your time when doing this, and if you make any mistakes, you can just tidy up with Cantor Blue. With the armor now fully highlighted, the next thing that we need to do is to pick out the metallic details. And for this, we're going to be using Iron Hand Steel. We're just going to edge highlight all the silver, just like what I'm doing here. And then just do little scratches and notches over the gun casing. Once that's done, don't forget to change your water, as you do not want to get any metallic flakes into the rest of your paint. With the silver details now highlighted, as well as the gun casing, the next thing that we need to do is to pick out the red details. And for this, we're going to be using Evil Sun Scarlet to pick out the bottom sections of the lenses. Once you're done with the lenses, don't forget to pick out the cables as well. With that section complete, the next thing that we need to do is to use Fire Dragon Bright to dot the inner corner of the eye lens. And there we go, the highlights are now complete. The next thing that we need to do is to focus in on doing the lightning pattern that's synonymous with the Night Lord's power armor. And for this, we're going to be using Lothian Blue as well as White Scar. So what I need to do is get some Lothian Blue onto my palette. There we go. Get a little bit of water. Thin it out. And get my brush to a nice sharp point. And what I'm looking to do here is to start to do jagged lines coming down from the top of the greave. Just like that. And you just want to get the lines going in at different angles, just to represent that lightning pattern. And with that stage complete, you can now see how once you've done a few of these lightning bolts, it really starts to pull the effect together quite nicely. The next thing that we need to do is to get some white scar and look to apply that into the center bit of each lightning bolt. So if you see what I'm doing here on the shoulder pad, I'm going to apply a little bit of white scar and just apply it to the center section of where the lightning starts to intersect. When using white scar, it's also a good time to dot the top section of the eye lens as well. And there we go, the lightning pattern is now complete. You can also see where I've added a dot of white scar to the far section of the eye lens. The next thing that we need to do is to move on to doing the base. And for this, we're going to be using Armageddon Dunes, Seraphim Sepia, Ushabti Bone, as well as Zandri Dust. So the first thing I need to do is get some Armageddon Dunes onto my texture tool. So I'm just going to use the large end of the texture tool. And then just apply that onto the base. And once you've got it onto the base with the larger end, just use the smaller end of the texture tool to push it amongst the greaves. Don't worry about getting it onto the greaves because it will just help to tie the model in with the base. Once the texture is fully on the base, just let it stand alone for an hour to dry. Now that the texture has dried, the next thing that we need to do is to wash it using Seraphim Sepia. With that stage complete, we now need to focus on highlighting the texture. And for this, we're going to be dry brushing using Ushabti Bone. So what I'm going to do is get some Ushabti Bone onto my brush and then start getting as much off of it as I can. Yeah, I'm happy with that. And then gently dry brushing over the top of the texture. If you catch the bottom sections of the boots, don't worry about this because it helps to tie the model in with the base. And now that the texture has been highlighted, the last thing that we need to do is to use Zandri Dust, heavily watered down, and applied over the bottom sections of the legs. What this will do is help to tie the model in with the base. So what I'm going to do is get some Zandri Dust onto my palette. A little bit more. And then just get quite a lot of water. Like that. And here you see I've made a wash consistency of the paint. And what I'm going to do is just apply it into the greaves. What this will do is just tie the model into the base even more. And there we are. With the Zandri dust now dry, our Night Lord is complete. All that's left to do is to paint the rim of the base. And as you can see here, we've done that using Steel Legion Drab. But you can do that using any color that matches the rest of your army. With the base completed and the room painted, our Night Lord Legionnaire is ready to drag the carcass of mankind's first solar empire into the light of a new Imperium. So there are just a couple of things to remember. When highlighting the model, take your time, and if you make any mistakes, you can easily just tidy up using the previous layer. Also, when doing the lightning effect, remember to go off at 45 degree angles, because what this will do is help build that jagged effect that you see in real life lightning. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this painting video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Night Lords, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye.